Hello everyone, welcome to our online class. So in today's class, we'll discuss last topic of test of significance of small samples, chi-square test for independence of attributes. Chi-square test, whatever you call it, chi-square test or chi-square test for independence of attribute. Okay, so what is attribute here actually? Attribute means a quality or characteristic. Attributes means what? Quality or characteristics. Okay, so when we have to use this chi-square test for independence of attributes, that means when the data is given in rows and columns, that means if two attributes are divided into two classes, in that case we have to use this chi-square test for independence of attributes. That means, for example, see here we have two classes like this. These values are A, B, C, D. Okay, so these are the observed frequencies. Observed frequencies, right? Then how to calculate expected frequencies here? So what is the row total here? A plus B is row total. And what is the row total here? C plus D. Then what is column total here? A plus C. And what is column total here? A plus D. So what is total? A plus B plus C plus D. Okay? So when this type of table is given, if you want to find chi-square test, how to calculate expected frequency. See here, if you want to calculate expected frequency of A, E of A is equal to its row total into its column total divided by total. Like this, you need to calculate expected frequency of each and every value, each and every observed frequencies. Okay, so whenever the data is classified into two-way table or three-way table, you have to use this chi-square test for independence of attributes method. Okay, so general formula is what? Chi-square formula is same. Chi-square formula is what? Summation oi minus ei whole square by EI, right? That formula is as it is, but only thing is calculation of expected frequencies will differ. Here chi-square is formula is what? Summation test statistic chi-square is equal summation OI minus EI whole square by EI. Degrees of freedom is what? V is equal to row minus 1 into column minus 1, where R is equal to number of rows and C is equal to number of columns. Where row R is equal to number of rows and C is equal to number of columns. Okay, so let us solve a problem, then you will understand how to solve this chi-square test for independence of attributes. Okay. See the first problem. From the following table, test whether the nature of work is independent of the gender of the worker. What he gave here, he says male stable how many? 40, unstable 20, female stable 10, unstable 30. Correct. So these are the observed frequencies. Whenever this type of table is given, observed frequencies, when a two-way table is given, so you have to use chi-square test for independence of attributes, right? Now, how to solve this type of problems? First of all, what we have to do? You need to write the null hypothesis, right? What is the null hypothesis here? See here, solution, null hypothesis H naught. What is the here? The nature of work is independent of the gender of the worker, right? Then work is independent of the gender. Correct. It won't depend on the gender. So what is asking here? Test whether the nature of the work is independent of the gender. So work is independent of the gender of the workers, right? So now what we have to calculate? Alternative hypothesis is what? Work is not independent. Alternative hypothesis H1, work is not independent. That means it dependent, right? Independent. Correct. Now what we have to calculate? Null hypothesis we took. Now, level of significance alpha, he didn't mention here, so you take alpha is 5%, right? then test statistic T, to calculate test statistic, we need to construct the table here. So what is the table, ma? So table, first what we need, he gave OI, then we need expected frequencies, then OI minus EI, correct? Then OI minus EI whole square, OI minus EI whole square, then OI minus EI whole square divided by EI ma, okay? So what are the observed frequencies here? Observed frequencies 40, 20, and 10 and 30. These are the observed frequencies, right? Observed frequencies 40, 20, 10, 30, right? Now what you have to calculate? Expected frequencies you have to calculate. How to calculate expected frequencies here? So first, what is row total here? 60. What is this row total, ma? 40. Then what is this row total? 50. What is this row total? 50. Now what is total, ma? 60 plus 40, 100. 50 plus 50 is what? 100. So if you want to calculate expected frequency of 40, how to calculate? 40 row total is how much? 60. 40 column total. 40 row total is how much? 60 into column total is how much? 50 divided by total, ma. Divided by total is how much? 100. That means how much you get here? 0, 0 got cancelled. You get 30. You get 30. Next, 20 expected frequency. Row total is how much? 60. Column total is how much? 50 divided by 100. This one also will give you 30. This one also will give you 30 mark. Understand here? Next, for 10, expected frequency for 10, row total is how much? 40. Column total is how much? 50 by 100. That means how much it is? 20. And here also, row total is how much, ma? For 30, row total is 40 into column total is 50 by 100. This one also will give you 20. Like this, you need to calculate expected frequencies of given observed frequencies. You need to calculate expected frequencies for given observed frequencies, right? Now, OI minus EI. 40 minus 30, 10, minus 10, minus 10, 10. Then do whole square, ma? 100, 100, 100, 100. Right, OI minus EI whole square by EI, 100 by 30, 100 by 30 is how much? 3.33, right, 3 digits. Then next, 100 by 30 is how much, ma? 3.333, 100 by 20 is how much? 5, 100 by 20 is how much? 5. So total 10, 16.66 I am getting. How much I am getting? 16.666 I am getting, ma. Right, now this is our table value. Now what we have to write here? Null hypothesis, level of significance alpha is how much? 5%. Test statistic, chi square is equal to summation OI minus EI whole square by EI. How much we got here? Calculator value, we got 16.66. How much we got? We got 16.66, correct. Now you need to calculate table value, no? See here, table chi square at alpha is equal 5% level of significance with V is equal to row minus 1 into column minus 1. How many rows we have? We have 2 rows. How many columns we have? We have 2 columns. So 1 is 2 minus 1 is 1 and 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 into 1 is 1 is 3.84. So table value I got 3.84. So calculated value is how much? 16.66. That means, so therefore, table chi square, calculated chi square is coming. It's not coming, no? Let me take 1 second. Now, so therefore, calculated chi square is greater than table chi square. Calculated chi square is greater than table chi square, right? If calculated value is greater than table value, what we have to do? You need to reject H naught. What is our H naught here? Worker is independent of the workies. Work is independent of the gender. It is wrong. That means you need to accept the alternative hypothesis. You need to accept the alternative hypothesis. That means work is not independent. Work is not independent. That means work is depend on the nature of the gender. That means if men will do more work or female will be more work, like that. It depends on the gender. Like this, you need to solve these chi square test problems when the independence of attributes are given. That means when a two-way table, three-way table is given, you need to solve in this way, ma. Understand this method? Okay, calculation of expected frequencies is only the important part here. So how to calculate row total? It's column total divided by total. Row total, it's column total divided by total. In this way, you need to calculate these all expected frequencies. Okay, we solve one more problem, you will understand more clear. See the next problem, what is telling here? From the following table, test whether there is any significant liking in the habit of taking soft drinks among the categories of employees. From the following table, test whether there is any significant liking in the habit of taking soft drinks among the categories of employees. Depending on the category of employees, he gave here three categories: clerks, faculty, and officers. So Pepsi is how many? 10, 25, 6, like the different is given. So he's asking whether there is any significant liking based on the employment, whether it is there or not, you need to test. Okay, so what we have to do here, first of all, you need to, these all are what observed frequencies. You need to construct the table and you need to find the expected frequencies, ma. Correct. So first of all, I am solving over here. So okay, you write down here, but I don't have a space, that's what I am writing here. What is the solution here? See the solution, first null hypothesis H naught, first point, null hypothesis H naught. What is our null hypothesis H naught? What we have to take? There is a significant liking in the habit of taking a soft drink. There is a significant liking in the habit of taking soft drinks. Alternative hypothesis H1, what we have to take? There is no significant liking. Then level of significance is what, ma? This one is what? Level of significance alpha, 5%. Then test statistic you have to calculate, right? To calculate test statistic, what we have to do, first of all, you need to construct the table here. So what is the required table, ma? OI, right? Then we need expected frequencies. Then we need OI minus EI, okay? So I am calculating here directly OI minus EI whole square by EI, ma. OI minus EI whole square by EI, I am calculating. So first of all, now let us take this observed frequencies of first one. What are the observed frequencies for first one? Observed frequencies 10, right? Then after that, after the 10, what we have? We have 25, right? Then next 25, after 25, we have 65. Here 15, 30, 65 coming. Next 50, then 60 and 30. Correct? So these are the, it's not coming, no? One second, ma. Let me adjust this. Yes. Okay. So these are the observed frequencies, right? Now you need to calculate expected frequencies, ma. How to calculate expected frequencies here? First, you need to write the row total, no? So what is the row total here? 10, 25. Okay, space is not there, huh? Okay, 1 second. I'm writing over here. Okay, 1 second. Yeah. So this is 1 and this is 2. Right. 25 is 65, how much, ma? 90 plus 10 is how much? Row total is 100. So here how much? 65. Row total is how much? 110. 140 row total. Column total is how much? 75 75 90 115. Correct. Then here 130 is how much? 160. So total how much it is? 75 190 150, we are getting, ma. Here 250 100 350. Correct. So total we are getting 350. This is what? 160. Okay, let me write. This is 160, ma. 160. So here OI minus EI whole square by EI. Right. OI minus whole square by EI. Okay. Now, so calculate expected frequencies. First of all, for 10, what is row total of 10? 100. What is column total, ma? 75. So that means 100 into 75 by total is how much? 350. 100 into 75 by total. How much we are getting? 100 into 75 by 350, we are getting total as 21.4. I am getting mark. Using calculator, how much I am getting? I am getting 21.4. Next, for 25, row total is how much? 100. Column total is how much? 115. So 100 into column total 115 by 350. So how much I am getting here? 32.9. Next, for this 65, row total is how much? 100. Column total is how much ma? 160 by 350. We are getting 45.71. How much I am getting? 45.71. Like this. So I am solving these all values. So for 15, row total is how much? 110. 110 into column total is how much? 75 by 350. So how much it is? 110 into 75 by 315, it is coming approximately 23.6. Similarly, for 30, I am getting 30, row total is 110, column, similarly, so I am getting this value as for 30, 36.1. For 65, I am getting 50.3. For 50, I am getting 30 ma. For 60, I am getting 46. For 30, what is 30 row total? 140 into 160 by 350. So 140 into 160 by 350, no? Yes. So I am getting approximately 64 I am getting now. Okay? So 64 I am getting. Understand here? So these three values I didn't write. You write this. For 30, what is row total? 110 into column total 115 by total 315. Right? Now calculate OI minus EI. 10 minus 21.4. 10 minus 21.4. So how much we get here? So minus 11.4. So let me take the calculator now. Next one, 25 minus 32.9. So it is coming approximately minus 7.9. Then next one, how much it is? 65 minus 45.71. This is coming 19.29. Next one, 15 minus 23.6. This one is coming minus 8.6. This one is coming minus 6.1. Then next, 65 minus 50.3. This one is coming 14.7. Ma, this is 20. This is 14. 30 minus 64 is how much? Minus 34. 30 minus 64 is how much? Minus 34. Right. Now, I am calculating this, total minus, how much we are getting here? 25 minus, correct only, no? Minus 7.98, right, correct. So, 19. Right. So, now, whole square by EI, I am getting 6.073 using calculator. 1.897 and here 8.151, here 3.134, and this will give you 1.031, then this will give you 4.3, and this will give you 400 by 20 square is how much? 400 by 50, approximately 400 by 30, right? So 13.333. okay, next 4.261, 18.062. okay, so using calculator, this total I am getting 60.2425 mark. Using calculator, this total I am getting 60.2425. okay, so this is a big problem actually. Now fourth point, test statistic chi square is equal to summation OI minus EI whole square by EI, correct? So that means chi square is equal to how much we are getting? 60.2425 we are getting here, right? Now what we have to do, you need to calculate table chi square, right? So table chi square at alpha is equal to 5% level of significance with the V is equal to row minus 1 into column minus 1. How many rows we have? 1, 2, 3. How many columns? 1, 2, 3. Don't take this column. This is total column. No.
So rows we have 3, columns we have 3. 3 minus 1, 2, 2 into 2 is 4. With the degrees of, with the V is equal to 4 degrees of freedom is table value I am getting 9.488. Okay. So but what happened here? So therefore calculated chi square is greater than table chi square. Why? Because calculated value, how much we got? We got 60.2425. Calculated value, how much we got, ma? 60.2425. So therefore calculated chi square is greater than table chi square. So what we have to do? You need to reject H naught. That means accept alternative hypothesis H1. You need to accept the alternative hypothesis. That means what we took here, H naught here, there is a significant liking is there. We took H naught. That we need to reject, no. So what is the conclusion here? What we have to accept here? You need to accept H1. That means there is no significant liking. That means we conclude that the habit of taking soft drink depends on the categories of employees. We reject the null hypothesis. That means the category, what we would write, conclude that the habit of taking soft drinks depends on the categories of employees. Like this, you need to solve these chi-square test for independence of attributes problem. That means whenever the data, whenever the observed frequencies are given in two-way table, or when two-way table or in three-way table, you need to construct the table like this. You need to calculate expected frequencies for each and every observed frequencies by taking its row total into its column total divided by its total value. These four values I did directly, so there is no space here. So you write down that four values, multiply, then you get the value. After that, OI minus EI, and calculate OI minus EI whole square by EI. Okay, so these are the four, these are the steps. First one is what? Null hypothesis H naught, there is a significant liking. Alternative hypothesis, there is no significant liking. So level of significance alpha, how much it is? 5%. Test statistic chi square is equal, formula is what? Summation OI minus EI whole square by EI. I got that value 60 point, how much I got? About 60.2425, right? So therefore table value is 60 point for rows into columns. Rows is 3, columns is 3. 3 minus 1 into 3 minus 1, 4 degrees of freedom is 9.488. So reject the null hypothesis, because calculated chi square is greater than table chi square. That means we conclude that the habit of taking soft drinks depends on categories of employees. It depends on categories of employees. Okay, so like this, you need to solve these all problems, ma. Okay, so we'll start. These are the topics in our unit 5. So we successfully completed this unit 5. So in unit 5, how many tests we have? Sample t test and f test and chi square test. In sample t test, we have two methods, single mean and two means. F test is one method, and chi square test also we have two methods. One is general chi square method, and another one is what? Chi square test for independence of attributes. First one is what? Chi square test for goodness of fit, and second one is what? Chi square test for independence of attributes. Understand this problem? Okay, so take down these two problems and practice these problems. You'll get more perfect. Okay, I'll give you one problem for homework, ma. Just solve that problem. See the problem, ma. Homework problem. Given the following contingency table for hair color and eye color. Given the following contingency table for hair color and eye color. What is asking? Is there good association between the two? Is there good association between the two? So here, these are what? Eye, blue eye, gray eye, brown eye. And here hair is what? Fair, brown and black. Okay. So you need to test the chi square test you need to use for independence of attributes, because eye and hair both are dependent. No, they are not independent, right? They both are, they both are independent. They are not dependent, no? So both are independent. So you need to test whether there is any association between them or not. So what we have to do here, null hypothesis, hair and eye color are independent. They both are not dependent, independent, right? So you need to calculate row total for these three, column total and calculate expected frequencies for each and every observed frequency. Then calculate here the table value. He says table value is 9.488, ma. So table, he gave in this, table chi square is equal to 9.488. Table chi square at 0.05. 5% level, he says 9.488. Okay, so solve this problem, you'll understand how to solve using chi-square test for independence of attributes. Okay, so thank you, we'll continue in next class.